Ice Climbers have had an interesting history in the competitive Super Smash Bros. Community, to say the least. They've been considered some of the most hated characters by the community for both Melee and Brawl, but that same ire doesn't really appear to be there for the duo in Smash Ultimate, and I think there's a pretty good reason for that. In Ultimate, the Ice Climbers will never get anywhere close to being a widely seen or top tier character, unlike they have done in every game they've previously appeared in. But before we jump into exactly why that is, I want to remind you about our on-demand coaching on ProGuides.com. Our new Pro Pass grants you free passes to our Play With Pros platform, along with a plethora of exclusive content, all posted daily. Make sure you don't miss our new Pro course with MKLeo himself, a new one with ESAM, as well as others coming soon. With that out of the way, let's do a bit of history lesson on Ice Climbers in Smash. In Super Smash Bros. Melee, the Ice Climbers were first introduced, and throughout the game's history of community voted tier list, they always hovered around middle of the pack. In a game with tons of characters with incredible high skill ceilings, ICs were up there as one of the most complex in the game. This large coming from a tool called desyncing, which allows a player to essentially put in inputs for both Popo and Nana, moving them almost as if they were two different characters operating on their own. This allows for some insanely cool looking tricks that no other character in Melee can come close to. But some of these tricks are even immensely difficult to execute for a seasoned vet playing in training mode, so you can imagine that being able to pull them off in a bracket requires a ton of grinding. But the payoff in choosing a slightly better option isn't often worth it for the much more execution required. But there is one option unique to ICs that can give the newest of players the ability to zero to death combo enemies like some of the gods of Melee: wobbling. For those unfamiliar with the technique, if ICs pummel an opponent at a certain BPM after a grab, they won't be able to mash out of it and can be pummeled infinitely. So why go for crazy desync options that are often worse than basic options other characters can do when you could just get one grab and take an enemy's stock? And that's what pretty much all of the active top level ICs do. They wave dash and move around the stage fishing for a grab to wobble enemies. But ICs still have a lot of other problems in Melee, so they only sit at the 7th best in the tier list, with the only infinite in the game that works consistently on every single character. The part of the picture on why Ice Climbers will never get the shine should be apparent from this, but let's jump over to Brawl to fill in a few more of the blanks. Super Smash Bros. Brawl is pretty much universally regarded as one of the best single player experiences in the Smash series, yet one of the lesser competitive experiences in the series as well. These claims about the competitive scene largely stem from how dominant Meta Knight is in the game, and how the meta was essentially shaped around which characters are the best at defeating Smash's most notorious S tier. This pretty bland meta and slow gameplay contributed to the death of the competitive scene for Brawl, which was a first, as both 64 and Melee still have a strong competitive following, whereas Brawl eventually dwindled down to single-digit tournaments held every year. And do you know who was gilded as the best character for dealing with Meta Knight and finished second on the final Brawl tier list? You guessed it, Ice Climbers. Their wobble was a little bit different in this game, using grab into grab into grab to zero to death opponents, but the idea was essentially the same. Ice Climbers were able to use a not too difficult to use technique to kill enemies off of one grab, which severely stunted the growth or need for IC's mains to learn any of the other fancy desync options. After the top two, you would have a bit of diversity between characters like Olimar, Falco, Marth, and Diddy Kong, but none of them could hold up to Ice Climbers' potential in the end. We never saw enough of an MK banned meta to see how Ice Climbers would fare, as they did have some shaky matchups, but they always proved to be a serious threat in the main meta. But yet again, Ice Climbers had the potential to be a unique and deeply technical character in a Smash game with the ability to control two characters at once, but an easy to execute infinite made it optimal for them to fish for grabs for another generation. Ice Climbers didn't make the jump to Smash 4 largely due to the hardware limitations of the 3DS, but they're back in Ultimate for the first time ever without an infinite. Or should I say, without an easily executable infinite that works on every character at any percent. And this has really followed us to see some incredible looking desync clips that have circulated around YouTube and Twitter that pull off some incredible things. But think back to those clips. How many of them were in training mode? And then of the ones that aren't in the controlled environment with infinite shots to get it right, how many of them were on quick play online? How many of these incredibly fancy and jaw-dropping IC moments have you seen that were pulled off in brackets? And how many Ice Climber mains can you name off the top of your head? You get what I'm saying. Ice Climbers have finally broken free of the chains that bind them to being a lame infinite character, and they're instead that platonic ideal version of the climbers that Papa Sakurai imagined all along. The only problem is that they're no longer a good character with an infinite and will never be a good character. Let's break down the two reasons why. First is that the level of execution to do some of their crazy tricks that Ice Climbers have had in their previous games is even less valuable here. There's so many characters in the game that ICs may spend hours and hours grinding out of this cool 0 to 80 option on Lucina in training mode, but if they run into a Jigglypuff, all that time is useless. And this is more a greater issue with the insane amount of characters in the game that top players like Leffen have talked about recently. But it becomes even more heightened with Ice Climbers because these combos that include desync are that much harder to execute in practice and in bracket, which more time needs to be sunk into practicing those potentially useless strings. So why do double or triple the work by playing Ice Climbers when you can play Joker or Wario or Pokemon Trainer or so many others in the cast who require a ton less work to get the same damage? Second is why I say the Climbers will never become a top tier. If by some grace of God, coding error, or unforeseen consequence that they do get an easy to execute infinite patch in the future, it would also certainly be hotfixed out. The design team for Smash Ultimate has been very clear that players' enjoyment is at the top of the list of concerns when balancing the game, and enjoyment does also mean more people buying the game, but that's probably just a coincidence. But just as Sakurai was reportedly disgusted seeing a player pull off a Smash 4 Bayo combo during the Ultimate Invitational, I can guarantee you that once he gets the first glimpse of a clip of Wobbling 3.0, the Climbers would get gutted. And this infinite is the only real thing that has made this pair good in the games they've been in, and there's no shot they are ever gonna get something like it in the era of patches. So I just don't think there's any bright light at the end of the tunnel for the ICs via updates either. And that about wraps up our video on why the Ice Climbers will never be good in Smash Ultimate. Let us know in the comments if you agree with the sentiments expressed in this video, or if you think there's some small hope that Nana and Popo can climb their way up to the top tier list through players like Big D. Make sure to subscribe to ProGuides and put those notifications on to make sure you don't miss out on any content on the competitive Ultimate scene in the future.